weather on the 8th with meteorologist Christine Ferreira.
Good morning. It is 6:38 right now. Let's take a live look in Ephrata. We are starting out with mainly clear sky. Some high clouds are starting to come in. And with those high clouds, temperatures will be capped off in the 30s today. So not hitting that 40 mark yet, but I do expect it tomorrow and for much of the 7-day forecast ahead. Right now, we'll do the News 8 Storm Team forecast. A mix of clouds and sunshine today, starting out with some sun and then seeing thickening high clouds throughout the afternoon. Temperature check, 32 to 36. That's about it for today. Still about 15 degrees below average in some parts. For tonight, mostly cloudy, chilly, but not as cold as what we've seen lately. We've been in the teens for the past several mornings, single digits too, but not the case due to cloud cover tonight. For tomorrow, mostly cloudy skies. Can't rule out an evening shower for you, especially possible in our southeasternmost counties. Chester, Lancaster, you might get brushed with a shower from the system that's going by offshore. Tomorrow's highs approaching 40. For right now, we're at 19 degrees in Harrisburg, 17 for Lancaster, also in Reading, doing 16 in Lebanon with 18s for York, Chambersburg, Gettysburg, and Carlisle. Live on Super Doppler 8, these are the high clouds that you see out there, but nothing falling out of these clouds. I don't expect any precipitation today. However, tomorrow is interesting. We have this area of low pressure which is developing over the Gulf that will move off the mid-Atlantic coast tomorrow and just may brush our southeastern counties. Two of our computer models are suggesting a slight chance of some light rain for us late in the day. Let's take a look. Here's what the predictor says for us today. High pressure over New England will gradually move offshore. It'll give us an easterly flow, so that'll start to pack in the clouds tonight and tomorrow morning as well. Here's that area of low pressure I just showed you over Florida. Tomorrow morning, we're dry, but by tomorrow evening, as it comes up, the back edge of that system might just clip our southeastern counties with a little bit of light rain. After that passes, we clear out, so Saturday will start sunny, followed by increasing clouds ahead of our next cold front. That drops in from the Great Lakes early Monday and may, or sorry, Sunday, and may even trigger a few flurries for us early Sunday. Don't forget, speaking of Sunday, early in the morning, 2 a.m., the clocks spring forward to become 3 a.m. Always a good idea as well when you do that to check the batteries in your smoke detector, at least test them and make sure your family knows what to do in the event of an emergency. Here's the extended forecast showing temperatures on the increase next week. Looking good. In fact, Monday, 48. Tuesday, 50, and then Wednesday, question mark on this one, it's going to be either Wednesday or Thursday where we could see a chance of a mix coming in. So it might be snow, it might be a mix, might be some rain to start. Difficult to pin down at this point so far out.
Okay.
We're not done with winter.
No, right. No. Apparently not.
At least until June.
Yeah, right.
April, you're
safely,
safe.
I don't know. I can't safely rule out the chance of snow. No, yeah. Not even. You know we get snow in March.
We do. Right. We get some big snow in March.
Especially if we have that cold air in place, which looks like it may be next week.
Okay. We'll see. All right. Thank you very much, Christine.
Thank you.